compelling detective story, a cloak and dagger action, and a romantic drama, all these stories were taken from real life. The history of Kazakhstan is inseparable from the world history. Reflections on History, our version.
Meeting over the centuries. It's the ancient Vár district in Budapest. This complex, which was designed as the architectural backdrop to the ancient castle, has already become an architectural treasure too. The Millennium Conquest of the Homeland was widely celebrated in Hungary in the early 20th century. They celebrated the 100th anniversary of the Hungarian settlement near the Danube River basin. The Fisherman's Bastion was built to mark the Millennium of Conquest of the Homeland. The white stone bastion has balustrades and seven towers. They're like a symbol of Magyar tribes that settled in these lands over a millennium ago. Where did they come from? Where was their homeland so long ago? Was it in the Caucasus, Kuban, the Volga region, or the Kazakh steppes? Let's follow the route. In general, the nation came here over various intervals. Turkic tribes moving from the east to west had become a tradition by the Kipchak epoch. Conquest of the homeland is considered one of the main national holidays here. Chapter 1. Known anonymous author? They have often done battle over this ancient chivalric romance. Scientists have argued whether they should believe the information given or not for over two centuries. The Hungarian people surpass everyone in their military skills and are descended from the Scythians, whose land was overpopulated since so many people lived there, and they lacked food and space. Then, seven rulers decided to leave and tried to settle in other lands, which they conquered tirelessly. After that, they decided to search for Pannonia, the land of King Attila, who was their ancestor. The only copy of the Deeds of the Hungarians manuscript written in the 13th century was found and published in Vienna 500 years later. Its author was some Master P, better known as the anonymous notary. Although we won't talk about him, he said, "I consider it to be the best to write reliable information about the way the Hungarians performed their deeds." The Hungarian nation was formed somewhere in the east, probably in the southern Ural. Recently, some traces indicating that this area included the northwestern part of modern Kazakhstan have also been found. The route description in general confirms this version. They went west through the desert areas for many days and then reached the Volga River, which was known as the Etil then. Prince Al-Mush headed the caravan carrying many thousands of people. According to different chronicles, his son Arpad was the head of the caravan. The Hungarian Arpad dynasty was descended from the Turkic people too. This fact was confirmed by many documentary written sources. We'll talk about this later. Now we'll continue following the historical route. The nomads went through the territory of modern Russia and reached Kiev. According to the medieval anonymous chronicler, they conquered the city. However, things settled down quickly and Kiev citizens were only laid under tribute. The Hungarian tribes came to the Carpathian Mountains at the end of the 9th century. They settled near the Danube River basin and in Pannonia. Veszprém is a capital of the wind and chiming bells. This city was formed during the times of Stephen, the first king of Hungary, by non-indigenous tribes in the late 9th century. After that, all Hungarian queens received their crown from a local bishop, which is why Veszprém is also called the City of Queens. In addition, it's also known as a city of unexpected hail. I've just been advised not to go outside because a hail is going to fall. A big hailstorm has already started. A local museum has more than 200,000 exhibits, many of which are related to the formation of the Kingdom of Hungary. Here in Visprem, we get a lot of excavation results showing that some parts of women's costumes are very similar to the parts of small Eastern but similar costumes. Chapter 2. Common Ground. The anonymous chronicler did not answer the question as to where the predecessors of the Hungarians came from. Another chronicle, written by Simon of Kirza at approximately the same time, didn't answer this question either. His work only contains information about the kinship between the Hungarians and Huns and their arrival from Scythian lands. It seems that history related the lost homeland had become quite topical by the 13th century. There's even a concept of the Turanian curse in poetic form. It says that when the Hungarians left the place where they had lived and moved to another place, they lost their homeland, but on the other hand, they found another one. The ancient area of nomads was attractive to them because it provided various opportunities for military and kindred unions and missionary work. In addition, it was the period of new threats from the Mongols. As a result, Bela IV of Hungary sent a few monks to the Kipchak steppe to search for Great Hungary, their ancestral homeland. Only one monk, who encountered a lot of adventures, managed to reach the country of the Eastern Hungarians, who consumed wolf meat and horse milk. Supposedly it was somewhere in the territory of modern Bashkortostan and Western Kazakhstan. Having found out that brother Julian was Hungarian, they welcomed him heartily, took to various houses and settlements and asked many questions about the king and kingdom of their Christian brothers. They listened to everything he told them about their beliefs and other things attentively. They could understand each other because the language they spoke was very similar to Hungarian. Most likely, the so-called Eastern Hungarians, or simply Kipchaks, were Turkic-speaking people in the 13th century. However, the version according to which the Eastern Hungarians were Finno-Ugric people is still considered basically true. The fact that the Hungarian language is Finno-Ugric is well known. However, the Hungarians lived together with the nomads, speaking the Turkic languages for a very long time, especially in the 6th to 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th centuries. It was discovered that the Pannonian Avars, who could speak the Turkic language, were there too. Vasily Tatishev was the author of the five-volume History of the Russian State. According to him, the Scythians were the ancestors of the Turkic peoples and Finno-Ugric tribes, including Germans. Probably a part of the European peoples can be included there as descendants of the Sarmatians as well. Do you understand what I mean? In this regard, it is possible to establish a link. The linguistic connection between centuries and people can be found in the centuries and among peoples. If you ask for alma at the Budapest market, every seller will sell you apples, even small ones, which are kicsi in Hungarian and kisi in Kazakh. Such words as kerek, which means I need, alakon, standing for short, and balta, meaning a hammer, are similar as well. There are a lot of similar words in Hungarian and Kazakh. For example, mother is Anya in Hungarian and Anna in Kazakh. My mother is Anyam in Hungarian and, as far as I know, Anam in Kazakh. We Hungarians call a father Atya and the Kazakhs say Ata. My father is Atyam and Atam, respectively. The search for the distant motherland didn't stop for centuries. Anmin Vambedi, in the guise of a dervish, crossed the Great Steppe in the 19th century. The famous Hungarian Turkologist tried to find confirmation of his theory, saying that the Saka, Scythians and Magyars were of Turkic origin. He was confident that the Hungarians had come from the Caspian region. After Vambari, another scientist called Tot Tibur studied anthropology. He visited the Turgay region in the Soviet period. Although he studied the Hungarian people and visited the Turgay region, he paid attention to the kinship between the two peoples. There is also a historical connection between the Hungarians and the Kazakhs. It was a very interesting process. They have made similar traditions and legends about a deer and two brothers, Madiar and Aldiar. Love for horses is in their nature too. As for DNA, the research carried out in the scientific laboratory showed a great similarity between the genotypes of the Magyars from Turgay and a group of Hungarians. Only in the 1980s could my husband István Mandoki conduct research because he thought he was a Kipchak. In fact, he was really from the Kipchaks. His ancestor had lived in Kazakh, the great Kipchak land. Even in his childhood, his father told him that they'd become Hungarians living in Europe, but his motherland was in Central Asia. He told him to find the Kipchak people, his land, and the land of their ancestors. Chapter 3, Close and Distant. It seems that the grass never grew on roads leading to Hungary. The Scythian collection in the National Museum in Budapest proves this fact. The number of artifacts keeps increasing year after year. These are golden deer of the Scythian period. Similar ones were found in Kazakhstan. There are a few migration stages in Hungarian history. The earliest exhibits of the Scythian epoch date back to the 8th century BC. Later, in the 4th century AD, the Huns started appearing on the banks of the Danube. In the middle of the 5th century, Europe shuddered under heavy hooves of Attila's massive cavalry charge. At the same time, Pannonia became the center of the Hunnic Empire. In the Middle Ages, Hungary was called the Kingdom of Huns. The migration of 40,000 Kipchaks under Khotun Khan in the 16th century is considered one of the last migration waves. However, Hungary had been formed as a state 4 centuries earlier, thanks to the migration of the 7 steppe tribes. We think there were more than 7 tribes. However, we have information only about 7. The legend has it that these 7 tribes reached the destination. They came, looked around, and remained. Almush from Attila's clan proclaimed his son Arpad the leader of the newcomers. The Byzantine emperor Constantine called him the great duke of the Turkic people. Although Arpad inherited his father's title, he had to share power with the co-regent Kursan for a few years in accordance with Turkic traditions. Kursan's descendants lived in ancient Budapest and bore the surname Kartel or Elder Il. The conquest of their motherland was made under military banners. The information provided in the chronicles included attacks on neighboring states and other conquests. This information was scarce until Vaik, descendant of Arpad, appeared on the historical arena. His name translates from Turkic as hero and leader. When being baptized, he took the name István and became the first king of Hungary. Later, István was canonized. He is considered the creator of Hungarian statehood. Epilogue. Sights worth seeing. One of the main sights of Budapest is beautiful in the moonlight or being lit by street lamps. It's beautiful even when it rains. Heroes Square and a nearby castle were constructed to mark the 1000th anniversary of Hungary. It is one of the most beautiful ensembles of the city and Hungarian history. There is the founder of the Arpad dynasty, leaders of the 6 other tribes and their descendants. Here is the anonymous chronicler. Their meeting took place centuries later.